What's up, guys? DJ back again, and we have two packages to open up today from Welcome Stranger. As usual, we got some Pokemon, we got some basketball, we got some PSA cards, whole bunch of randomness. Let's get into it. Alrighty, guys, as I said before, I have bought once again from Welcome Stranger. There's a first edition stamp. This is a business card. I have shown his card heaps of times before, but very reliable. Awesome place to buy some randomness of Pokemon and some great investments. So consider checking them out. They've got a Facebook page. First off, like I said before, we have some random boosters we're going to open up today. We got some Power Rangers. We got some Superman. We got some Marvel Spider-Man stuff. And we got a Terminator one. But before we open these, let's go through some of the Pokemon cards that I bought some singles. We got a Pinsir holographic from Jungle, a Chansey holographic base set, Clefairy from base set holographic, and a Kangaskhan. I believe all four of these cost me about $27, so a decent price just to chuck into my binder. Nothing too, nothing that I'm going to grade seriously or anything like that. But yeah, these will come really nicely into my collection. We've got some PSA graded cards for you basketball fans out there. We've got a PSA 8 Michael Jordan Bulls checklist. And let's go to back there. Can't remember the price, to be honest, but I will put it up somewhere on here. But fairly cool. I am a huge fan of Michael Jordan and basketball in general. Been playing since I was 5 years old. But yeah, there's a bit of a list there you can check out if you want to pause the video. The next PSA card we have is another Michael Jordan. PSA 9 this time. In flight. I am kind of going through these ones a bit quicker because I know most guys in the channel are here for Pokemon stuff. But yeah, I like to share some of the other things I am also interested in. And the last PSA graded card we have is actually a Pokemon card. It's a Rocket Simonchan PSA 9. Also a great deal. Can't remember the price. Maybe $26. $26, Japanese holographic. It's not as expensive as the English holographic version, but nonetheless, it was a cheap buy, already graded. I thought it was worth it, and I like Hitmonchan. He's a pretty cool guy. So there we go. We got three PSA graded cards and some of those Wotc holos from the older sets, base set and jungle. Now let's get cracking into some of these randomness of booster packs. All of these things I am quite a fan of. Maybe Power Rangers I didn't really get into. So I might start off with that first and work our way through. Now I believe these Spider-Man ones, they're actually first edition. There's 14 cards in a pack of these, so it's really thick. So it'll be quite interesting. And that is actually an art set. So that's Spider-Man and the Green Goblin. Pretty cool. So let's get into Power Rangers first for you Power Ranger fans. 8 cards per pack. And I was thinking of keeping these sealed. But let's be honest. I have a particular fan that likes these random cards, booster packs that I open. So I thought I'd continue the trend, and this is the best place to buy some of these random cards or boosters. And I'm trying to keep these in decent shape just in case they are worth something. I have no idea. Most of these boosters were only like $15. Oh, no, sorry. $15. $5 each. Some were 6 or 7. I can't really remember. Prices will be up somewhere. Or sometimes I just get them as a bonus when I buy other things through auction. And like I said before, I wasn't a huge Power Ranger fan, so I have no idea what some of these pictures mean, or I think that might be a double. And a bit of a description in the back, just in case you guys are true fans of Power Rangers or anything and you want to read that. Pink Ranger. But Power Rangers was a big thing in the 90s as well, just like Pokemon. Pretty sure it was on Cheese TV as well as Pokemon. So, I guess it's always fitting. These are really sharp corners. I reckon you can get paper cut just by like touching these corners. And yeah, I'll try to keep these in great condition. Probably sleeve them up or something, just in case the, you know, someone might want to grade them or something. And yeah, I have no idea. I've never seen Power Ranger booster packs before. And this looks like the special card of the set. It's got a bit of a pattern there. Bit of a different texture. Saluguana. Must be a bad guy. Doesn't look like one of the good guys or the friendly guys. And the last card is this rainbow. The new season, Power Rangers. Must be Red Ranger or something. Adam, the new Black Ranger. Oh, Black Ranger. The bonus card 3. Alright guys, so that is the Power Rangers booster pack. Done and dusted. Let's get into a Terminator one. I am a Terminator fan. The new movie was, acceptable. I'm not much of a hater of, a lot of guys say, you know, they're very critical of the new movies that they make. They're really old school, they really like the first and second, and that's it. I kind of liked all of them, I really didn't mind all of them. I'm not too fussy. Okay, so let's have a look at these. So that's what, I think that's what the back looks like. Let's go to that side. Makeshift barricade. Oh, it's an actual game. Rotate your character anytime during the staging round. Okay, so you can actually play this as a game. That's the back. So, much like a Pokemon card, except these are pictures from the movie and a bit of an attack, I think. Once again, not sure if these are worth anything. But yeah. Not too bad. It looks like it's been made in the year 2000, so it's a 20-year-old card. Human Intuition. Remington 870. Let me know if you guys like these random boosters. I mean, it's quite fun to see different types of booster packs being opened. Although, I should probably stick to Pokemon a lot more. Sometimes you just can't help it. I believe it's upside down. Yeah, I think this one cost $5, so it wasn't that much. Not much to see, but it has a similar, you know, border, and there's a picture, and then on the back, it's got the same back for every single one, kind of like the Pokemon cards. Dancing. That was the final card. I don't know which ones are rare. There's like no such thing as a rare or a super rare or anything like that in Terminator 1. Let's get into Superman. This must be from the movie. Should be quite interesting. Superman is a bit plain for me. As a superhero, he was alright. I just find him a bit, boring. Ooh, interesting. I'm not sure if that's the rare card. Ooh, these are very sharp too, so I've got to look after these. It's got really cool engraving on the side, on the border. Don't know if anything on the back. Wow, they really stick together. That's what the back looks like. Sorry, I'm holding it really awkwardly. I'm trying to keep these in nice condition. Superman getting beat up. I thought that was an R in the background. It could have been like a Team Rocket thing. But obviously it is not. It starts with a B. Let's see if I can take it off. High tech. Bit of an explanation there, I guess. See the engraving? That engraving goes to the other side. That's interesting. Looks like a Lex Luthor card. Not sure where these pictures are from. These are probably just either from the comic or something. Another Superman. These corners are really sharp. I'm guessing if you were, if I was to grade these, they'd have to be like, you know, they'd grade how sharp the edges were and stuff. Last Son of Krypton. Superman beat up. Bit of a signature there, Daniel Horn. Not sure what that means. There must be Lois Lane in the background too. Probably went up against Doomsday, yeah, sounds about right. When falls the hero. Superman threw himself at Doomsday in a final ferocious effort. Sounds about right. Last card of this booster. Superman tanking up. It's funny how Superman looks a little different in each photo. I don't know. Same artist, same different costume sometimes. I don't know. Anyway, that is the Superman booster pack. A Batman booster pack would probably be a bit more fun, but nevertheless, he was probably my favorite character out of the DC, Batman. Let's get into these Marvels and call it a day. So, these ones should be quite big. These are first edition. Not sure if they mean much or... Obviously, they're not that worth... My English is gone. They're not worth that much at the moment because if I can buy these booster packs for about $5, I'm sure you can buy them somewhere else. That's what the back looks like, VS Systems. And let's go through these. All first edition stamped over there on the corner. Rocket Racer. Bit of a description there too. These cards are brand spanking new. Interesting. We got an E there. I'm not too sure what that means, but it might be part of the first edition. Boomerang. Ooh, nice artwork there. Grounded. Silver Sable. Jessica Drew. Fight to the finish. Hey, that's Wolverine and Spider-Man. Pretty cool. Purple Man. What a funny name, Purple Man. Ooh, holographic? Yes. Spider-Man senses. Tell the difference in that. That's definitely some sort of rare card. Apologies, I haven't really researched that much on any of these boosters or anything like that. So, if you know a lot more than I do, feel free to comment in the section. In the comment section, let me know, educate me. Otherwise, I mean, I'm going to sleeve them up anyway, put them in a binder. And who knows? Maybe I hit the jackpot with that Spider-Man holo. Cloak, smokescreen. Hey, that guy must be from the new Spider-Man movie. I didn't watch, but yeah. With Jake Gyllenhaal. Alright, last booster pack. Spider-Man, give us some luck. First edition. There was one holographic card in that other one, so there must be one holo in this. Hopefully it's another Spider-Man. Different picture though. First edition. Alright, let's bring this on to its close. Vulture. Surrounded. Hey, it's got multiple of those Jake Gyllenhaal guys. Spider-Man. Pretty sure Spider-Man was Stan Lee's favorite Marvel character. I think someone said that after he died, or he mentioned it in an interview or something. Can't remember. Can't really remember. Shadowcat. Aerial Supremacy. Wow, they're really putting the X-Men with these Spider-Man. Pretty sure that's Rogue and Storm and... I don't know, maybe Angel or something in the background. Dark Arc, Slab. Cartoonized. Oh, I just realized the background's a little bit different. Color-wise. And there's the holo surrounded. So we have the non-holo version, and now we have the holo. Yeah. Would have been cool to get something different, but that's alright. Julia Carpenter, Spider-Woman. Not bad. Cloak, so we got some double. Smokescreen, another double. Hobgoblin. Alright. And last card is a Human Torch from Fantastic Four, I believe. Not too bad. There's the back. Let me know what you guys think of this opening. We had some Spider-Man, we had some Superman, we had a bit of everything. Power Rangers, Terminator. This is a Pokemon channel, so don't get mistaken by all this randomness. I just kind of like to throw things in. But anyway, let me know what you think of what I got. This is probably the only real investment purchase for the day, like Pokemon purchase. All the other random stuff will be sleeved, and I guess I'll store them until I don't really need them or anything, and then sell them off or something. Hopefully these Jordan cards may grow in value. Yeah, you just really never know with basketball cards or sport cards. With these ones anyway, these are, you know, 91. It's not like those baseball cards from the 50s or anything like that. But who knows, maybe in another 20 years' time, it'd be worth a lot more. But anyway, like, subscribe, comment below, anything you want. I'll see you guys next video. Ciao.